Yeah, but I don't think it's going to be too much trouble getting it off. I think we can get it off fairly easily here.
What do I need?
Well, hello, and welcome to Shadetree Mechanic. You know, you mentioned the word turbocharger, and the first thing you think about is high performance. And that's understandable because turbochargers have been associated with racing engines for a long period of time. But now you'll find them fairly commonplace on passenger car engines.
Now, today we're going to cover and dispel some of the myths about turbochargers, talk about how to take care of them, and show you, these things generate a lot of power from small engines.
You know, Sam's right. It's sort of like the quicker picker-upper. You can generate some quick power just by bolting these things on. They're designed to run for a long period of time. They're fairly simple, but you have to know how to take care of them.
You know, all the failures can be traced to a lack of really basic maintenance. And you know the maintenance is basic on these.
That's right, like changing the oil and doing it on a regular basis.
Using the right kind of oil.
That's exactly right. And one other common mistake that people make is not letting the engine run down or letting it idle before they shut the engine off.
That's a good point. Your turbocharger spins probably somewhere around 80 to 100,000 RPM. It's really moving. When you shut the engine off hot, of course, the turbocharger keeps spinning. You've stopped the oil pressure, and you'll damage the bearings and seals. And what a turbocharger is, basically, is like a pair of water wheels, and one of them is driven by the exhaust gases that are normally wasted out the tailpipe. The other one spins inside a compressor, and it forces air down the engine's throat into the cylinders and effectively increases power.
Now, here's the replacement turbocharger unit that we're talking about. We get this from Turbo City. When you order one, this is what you'll get. They'll send you the whole complete unit, so it makes it easy to install. This is the turbo section. This is the compressor section. Now, I have a cutaway that'll give us a little bit better idea of what we're talking about. And here's what we're looking at. This is the heart of your turbocharger. Now, Sam had mentioned the water wheels. Well, in turbo talk, this is called an impeller. This is the exhaust impeller, and this is the impeller for the compressor side. Now, they're hooked together with a common shaft right here. Now, as this spins, it'll pull air in on the intake side. Now, let's go back here to our replacement unit, and we can see exactly how it works. The exhaust gases flow up through here, through our turbocharging housing, and they'll spin the impeller, which will draw intake air through this side and force it out through here into the intake manifold. Now, I have a graphic that'll show you exactly how this works. The turbocharger is made up of two sections, the turbine section and the compressor section. The blades of the turbine are driven by the exhaust gases as they exit the exhaust manifold. The turbine blades and the compressor blades are attached to a common shaft. The pressure of the hot exhaust gases causes the turbine to spin and forces the compressor blades to spin at the same time. As the compressor blades spin within its housing, the intake air is pressurized and is forced through the intake manifold into the cylinders. This pressurization effectively raises the compression of the engine and creates additional horsepower.
You know, the good news is all that additional horsepower we get free because we're not using a belt to drive it or anything. We're using the waste exhaust gases to spin it.
You know, that's right. And you can generate a lot of horsepower out of one of these small turbos. But if you think you can do it with this, what do you think you do with this big dude right here?
Well, this big dude obviously is for a much larger displacement engine. This is off a big diesel truck. And a lot of your diesel trucks are turbocharged. And that's why when you hear them passing you on the freeway and you hear that whistle or that singing, that's what you're hearing is the turbocharger.
That's what it takes to haul the load. We're going to take a short break. When we come back, we're going to get started on our turbocharger unit. So stay with us.
This is a big unit, too.
$3,000 this thing costs.
Yeah, let's go ahead and put this one on.
A turbocharger's turbine spins up to 120,000 revolutions per minute.
One engine was filled with Castrol Simtec, a full synthetic oil, the rest with conventional oils. They were then drained and started without oil to prove a point. You see, Simtec has a unique molecular structure that bonds to engine parts. Lab tests show it leaves a layer of protection far stronger than conventional oil. And if Simtec protects this well now, imagine if you leave it in. Castrol Simtec protects in ways other oils can't. Try Castrol Simtec, now also available in a 10W30.
It's a major breakthrough in auto protectant technology. Formula 2001 Super Protectant. It provides a more brilliant, longer-lasting shine than Armorall on vinyl and leather. And look, in the Arizona desert, Formula 2001 brought back the shine to UV-faded vinyl, rubber, even leather. Get the new standard in automotive protectant technology. Formula 2001, with 50% more active shining ingredients than Armorall. Get Formula 2001 products today.
Most trackers can follow the trail only as long as the weather holds out. Unless it's a tracker spurred on with genuine AC spark plugs. AC plugs fire faster than lightning for performance so smooth, even the thunder claps. And that'll keep your engine on the trail to a longer life.
Call 1-800-AC-DELCO. It's like buying time.
So better track down some AC spark plugs.
When you're looking for a powerful tractor, you can't get one more powerful than this. It's got an engine bigger than your house. It's also got something in common with every new Cub Cadet tractor.
A steel drive shaft,
not a belt, like other tractors.
Every Cub Cadet, every horsepower level. Of course, no Cub Cadet has this much horsepower. We make your yard look a lot nicer. If you want shaft drive, just look for Cub Cadet.
Well, welcome back to Shadetree Mechanic. Well, as you can see, we got the hood off of our Thunderbird. The reason we did that is so it makes it easier for us to work on the car, plus it's easier for you to see what we're doing. Now, one of the first things we're going to do is take off the intercooler. Now, that's what this unit is right here. This is fairly common to a lot of cars with turbochargers. The way it works, or what it really is nothing more than a radiator to help cool your intake charge. What happens is the air is pumped up from the turbocharger into the intercooler. The intercooler then will help cool that charge, because anytime you compress air, you heat it. Once you cool the air, then it flows into the intake manifold. Cooler air helps you generate a lot more horsepower.
That's right, that's what you take and pack the old manifolds with ice on a race car.
Exactly right.
Some of the other drawbacks you have with a turbocharged car, you know, we talked about free horsepower and generating a lot of power out of a small engine, but when you turbocharge, you develop so much compression, you usually need to use a little higher octane fuel, and you also can get what they call turbo lag in the industry. It's a little hesitation until the turbocharger catches up. That can be annoying to some people, but actually they've got these later turbochargers. They're pretty smooth, and they've eliminated the majority of turbo lag.
You know, one other point, too, with turbocharged cars is they generate a lot of underhood temperature or heat. Now, a way they combat a lot of that is with heat shields around the turbocharger. Now, over a period of time, this heat shield can get brittle due to all the heat cycles. When that happens, they'll crack and they can cause some vibration. So if you've got a turbocharged car that's got quite a few miles on it and you start to hearing a lot of vibrations at certain RPM, start checking some of that heat shield and you'll probably find cracks in it somewhere.
They get enough heat in there, they're tough on exhaust.
Exactly.
First thing we're going to do is remove this intercooler, and we start here by taking these bolts off.
Next, we'll remove the hose clamps. Okay, I think we're all loose. Here, hold it. Can you get it? All right. Okay, I think it should come out now. It's free there.
Here we go.
Oh, look at there.
Yep.
I think
just like we thought.
There's a problem.
Ah, nasty. Okay, the problem we're having with this Ford is smoking up the tailpipe, and we're suspicious because it's turbocharged that that's where we're getting it. By pulling off the intercooler, we can see in the compressor section down here, we've got oil. When you've got oil down there, that means the turbocharger's got bad seals. Probably the bearings are worn. Car's just been mistreated and not well maintained. Okay, what we've got here is, of course, you can see this is the turbocharger assembly like we showed you out on the bench, mounted right here in the exhaust stream. Here's your exhaust manifold where it flows into the turbine section. And we've got a steel pipe here we've got to disconnect that goes to the crankcase vent. We've got a couple of vacuum lines. And let me give you a little tip about vacuum lines, by the way. We've already disconnected two. Okay, and we're going to have more vacuum lines to disconnect, so you should mark them so you know where they go back. This little pipe right here is the oil feed for the turbocharger. We're going to disconnect that. And we've got two little pipes here that are hooked into the cooling system that run into the body.
You know, this is unique to this particular vehicle. It doesn't always take, it's not always the same on every turbocharger. But in this particular case, they've run the coolant lines into the center section of the turbocharger to help cool that bearing. This will help reduce the coking or the burning of the oil onto the shaft. So this is a pretty good item.
Yeah, it helps to keep it cool. Okay, first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to disconnect the bellows from the airflow meter to the turbocharger right here. Okay, on this bellows, we've got clamps on both ends. Loosen those, and then we should be able to slide the bellows right out. Now we'll just remove these vacuum lines.
We'll remove this mounting bracket here. And then the vent line.
Okay,
Next, we'll remove the oil line. Next, we'll remove our water lines. It's always a good idea to use a tubing wrench on these particular applications so you don't round off the hex. A little bit of water will flow out so you have a catch pan underneath. All right, now we got the lower coolant tube loose. Now, when you get it loose, you're going to find coolant flowing out of it. So the way you stop that is take and slide a hose right over the end of it, like this. That way, you don't lose too much coolant. Just keep the end up high like that, and you're in good shape.
Yeah, you saw Dave take this bracket off. This is the intercooler bracket. It was mounted right here in this stud, okay? Well, when you take this off, you'll see that we didn't even loosen the nut. And you see this rust here? Well, all this rust means that this thing was vibrating and chattering. Just like Dave said, you'll get some buzzes and vibrations. This will be real hard to find.
All right, now the next thing we're going to take off will be the O2 sensor. And usually you need about a 7/8 wrench on this. There we go.
Sometimes you need one of those oxygen sensor sockets.
You'll need a special wrench at times for that. Okay, now we got the O2 sensor out. And let me see, we got everything unhooked here. I guess the last thing we'll do is we'll go ahead and we'll spray the nuts and bolts down real good with some penetrating oil. And while that's soaking, we'll raise the car up and get the exhaust pipe off of it.
You know, this bracket didn't crack, and it's amazing it was loose and it didn't crack. You know? Okay, we've soaked the two bolts down, holding the exhaust manifold, or exhaust pipe to the exhaust manifold. I'm going to remove those now.
All right, now there's some other nuts and bolts that we got to worry about while we're under here. There's four of them that'll hold the turbocharger onto the exhaust manifold, two of which we got to remove while we got the car up here on the lift. There's also the oil return line that we have to remove.
We got these studs sticking out here. There's a nut on this stud, one on the backside, and of course, this is the oil return line right here.
Okay, now, while we have the car up on the lift, it's always a good idea to change the oil because you don't want to put a new turbocharger on a car and then leave the old oil in it. So now's the time to change it. We're going to take a short break, so stay with us.
This one here now.
Okay.
I'm holding this exhaust pipe up.
All right, got it.
Hit me in the head. Okay?
Go ahead.
Over 150,000 turbocharged units are replaced every year in the U.S.
Brought to you by Chevy Trucks, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road.
My hands were steady. My eyes were clear and bright. My walk had purpose. My steps were quick and light.
These are the men and women who make Chevy trucks.
I held firm to what I felt was right, like a rock.
Considering the quality of our people, it's no wonder they build the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road.
Oh, like a rock!
I thought I was smart. I paid less for another protectant. It said it shined like Armorall, so I figured it protected like Armorall, too. But it didn't.
Armorall provides superior protection against car vinyl discoloration.
For this, baby, I'm only using Armorall.
The TNN Bass Tournament of Champions contest. And now we're offering you a chance to compete at home on Super Nintendo or Sega Genesis. You could win some great prizes like Tracker Bass Boats, Team Daiwa Fishing Gear for the Rance Fish Finders, Bass Pro Shop gift certificates, and more. To enter and compete, you'll need the game, and you're gonna need the rules. Get the game wherever Nintendo and Sega Genesis are sold. To get the rules, send a self-addressed envelope to this address. Or call 612-467-1400. Or visit your local participating retailer.
Come on. Okay, well, welcome back, folks. As you can see, things aren't going quite as well as we had hoped. And true to form, things do happen. We had a real problem trying to get one of the nuts off the bottom of the turbocharger. And I'm going to see if you can see it out up here. It's a real tight area right about right there. That nut almost didn't come off. In fact, we had to take an old wrench, modify it a little bit by grinding it down in order to get the nut off. Now we got it off, and we're having trouble getting the oil pipe off.
You know, they build these cars, they build them to be lightweight, perform well, get good gas mileage, and be easy to put together in the assembly line. Not easy for the technician to service.
You know, if manufacturers ever build a car that was easy to work on, they'd really have something.
That's for sure. Let's go ahead and get this mine off.
I don't want to say I told you so, Sam, but...
Well, we would have got it off if that thing didn't turn off.
I know. All right, let's get these other nuts off. Next, we'll get these nuts off the exhaust manifold right here that holds the turbo on. Oh, boy, I'm glad we soaked those things.
Yeah, you want to break one of those studs. You break that in the manifold, you get a problem.
Yeah, let me get this other one loose.
Just hold this for you.
Here, now you get that.
Let me get this bracket off here, get this oil line out of the way.
Yeah, don't bend it any more than you have to.
I won't. I'm not bending it at all.
They're awful to try to get back in.
That can be your job.
I do, you do that.
Watch
yourself.
Okay,
I got it.
All right.
Good.
There you go.
All right, now go ahead and strip this off.
All right. Well, what we've got here is, of course, I'm going to take off the gasket that goes between the turbocharger housing and the exhaust manifold. These are the four studs, and these two lower ones, the bolts on these were just really tough to get at. And now I'm going to go after this oil return line, which we loosened up but weren't able to get off.
Well, now the fun part begins. This is the easy part, and that is all we have to do is just transfer these fittings, the two water fittings and the oil fitting over here to our new unit. Also, we'll take off this housing right here and transfer that over to the compressor side of our new unit. Now, we got the whole complete unit from Turbo City. And the reason we did that is, first of all, it comes complete, even with a brand new wastegate. And this is important because this one's got a lot of miles on it. Wastegate's designed to control or limit the amount of boost you get into your engine. If you get too much, you can cause some problems. This is preset, so you only get a certain amount, and it works just fine. Now, if you want to work a little harder and save yourself a few dollars, you can get just a brand new center section from Turbo City. And if you get one of these, all you have to do then is take off your old compressor and your turbo housing. They'll separate right here, take them apart, and then mount them on your new housing here. This is a little bit more work. You also want to be very careful that you don't accidentally bend or damage any of these impellers, because if you do, you could have a problem. These things spin upward to 150,000 RPM, so balance is very, very critical with the new impeller. Now, if you order your turbocharger from Turbo City, they have a complete catalog that has all kind of parts, all kinds of information in it that you can use. Also, if you're going to build a turbocharged engine up from scratch, again, they've got everything you'd ever need to do that. Good folks to work with, give them a call. They're in Orange, California. They'll be happy to work with you on that. And incidentally, once you get your new turbocharging unit, save the box that it came in, because you want to send the old unit back. It's an exchange program. Saves you a little money that way. Well, let's go ahead and get started and get our fittings off here.
Okay, let me give you some tips to make your job go easier. I'm removing this oil return pipe. By the way, Dave, how are you doing over there with those fittings?
Just about having.
Great. Okay, this oil return line is where the oil dumps back into the crankcase. Now, when the oil coming out of your turbocharger is real hot, and it can tend to coke up in here, this is already starting to build some on the edge. And if you get enough coke in here, of course, what happens is, or carbon, that's what it is, this line can get plugged. Always replace these. They're cheap. Put a new gasket there. It's good insurance for your replacement turbocharger. Next thing is, we've got a gasket here, and this metal gasket may look okay to you, but it's a one-time deal. We've got our new gasket, okay, and this gasket has a ring embossed around it. That ring is going to seal when you bolt it down. So when you put it in, really doesn't matter as long as the surface is good and clean, which way it faces. You put it on there. Once you bolt it up, of course, then it crushes and makes a seal. It's a one-time gasket. Another good tip is all your vacuum lines, and there are a lot of them going to a turbocharged engine, inspect them closely, especially these two. They go to the boost sensor. The computer opens and closes the wastegate by vacuum signals to this sensor. Now, what happens is, as you're wastegate closes, it causes the turbo to drive, gives you more boost, and powers up the engine. If you get too much boost, you overstress the engine, you can break a piston or bend a rod. So it's important that these things work good. And one other tip, when you've got a turbo engine, you're going to change the oil and filter every 3,000 miles or less. When you drain the oil and filter and put a new filter in, when you first start the car up, the filter's got to fill up. And that time that filter's taken to fill up, the turbocharger's spinning dry. So what you should do is change the oil and filter, refill the oil, then disarm the coil primary. Pull the wires off the coil,
Spin the engine till the light goes out or the gauge comes up. Then you've primed your oil system, got oil to the turbocharger, plug the wires back on, fire it up. If you do that every time, it'll add a lot of life to your turbocharger.
Okay, Dave, we're about ready to put that on.
All right, we're ready here. Screw that return pipe first.
Okay, there you go.
Let's screw this in the block.
That
first.
Should make life easier this time.
Yeah, I'm having a new one. That in place.
Those things can be a bear.
Okay.
Here you go.
I'm ready. All
right. Not a whole bunch of room to work right here.
Sort of an area where one person has to do it, and that's about it, isn't it?
Yeah.
You need some help in there?
No, I've got it. It's just tight wrestling in here.
Okay, there you almost have it.
Yeah.
Well, sometimes these things can go in a little, almost as tough as they come out. In this case, it's not too bad, actually.
Well, all I'm going to do now is set this down here.
There you go.
Line it up with the studs, and then I'll put the two top nuts on. Just get it down just a little bit.
Flange.
Yeah.
And a stud.
There we go.
There you go.
Yeah.
Now you're almost home free.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. This nut on right here.
Yeah, now you don't forget that nut back there with that housing.
I'm just going to start this one here.
All right, now install the lower water line. Now the upper water line. Now you want to start all these lines by hand first. Get them all started, then you can tighten them up later with the wrench. Now we install our vent line. And the oil feed line. Now we'll tighten them up with the wrench.
Okay, those are all tight, yeah.
Good.
All I got left now is to hook up some of these vacuum lines.
Remember which way they go?
Yeah, they're pretty self-explanatory, and I also knew where they went.
Also, we got to put in our new O2 sensor right down here. And after we do that, then we'll raise the car up, hook up the exhaust pipe, and the infamous oil return line that we had so much problems with.
Really? When we set the car back down, all we need to do is reinstall the intercooler, the reverse procedure of taking it off, make sure the vacuum lines are hooked up right. We'll be ready to start this up and run.
Well, we got quite a bit left to do on this. In the meantime, we're going to take a short break. When we come back, we're going to talk about new products, so stay with us. Now, what's the torque spec on this O2 sensor?
They're not real tight, about 35.
Fill the turbocharger's oil inlet port with clean engine oil before connecting the oil feed hose to the turbocharger.
If you settle for a remanufactured engine without a brand name, be sure you've got a pair of name brand shoes. AC Delco Engines, the national brand name with the nationwide warranty. Call for a location near you. Of course, if you come in on foot, we'll understand.
Before introduction, a Moen faucet is tested at least 500,000 times against leaks and drips. So it's hard to find a more reliable faucet, no matter how you look at it. Moen. Buy it for looks. Buy it for life.
One of these hammers is jacketed in high-impact polycarbonate. The other one is broken. The fiberglass jacketed hammer from Stanley.
You just spray it on.
Quicksilver wheel cleaner from Armorall. Just spray it on, and then just spray it off.
That's it.
Quicksilver wheel cleaner.
It's time for this week's secret clue on how to catch the big ones in the TNN Bass Tournament of Champions contest on Super Nintendo and Sega Genesis. You ready, Sinker?
No, I can't find a pencil or paper.
Use your depth finder to sound out the fish in the lake. Mind weather conditions. Some lures work better on sunny days, and others work better in the rain. Win great prizes in the TNN Bass Tournament of Champions contest. Watch TNN Outdoors for more details.
Found them.
Coming up on NHRA Today, we'll go down under for a report on the Australian Nationals, plus all the latest news from the Fram Southern Nationals.
NHRA Today, 6:30 p.m., 5:30 Central on TNN Motorsports.
We got compressed air.
Well, welcome back to Shadetree Mechanic. You know, there's nothing better in a shop than a good source of compressed air, coupled with some air tools. And this is a model we've been using around the garage here lately. This is from Ingersoll Rand. This is the IR2131 half-inch drive ultra-duty impact wrench. This is brand new, and it's a beauty.
You got an air fitting in it for me?
Yeah, here you go.
Great. Well, what makes this gun so special is it's got an ultralight composite housing with a steel hammer case, and of course, that makes it nice and balanced. The exhaust comes out the bottom, the air hose has a 360-degree swivel, and it's got a torque management system on the back. We've got four settings, from 50 foot-pounds to 450 foot-pounds forward. You've got push-button reverse, and that gives you 600 foot-pounds in reverse. It's a wonderful gun. It's about $200. You can buy it from Tool Jobbers, or from you can contact Ingersoll Rand in Liberty Corners, New Jersey. Dave, this sure is going to save a lot of wheel damage.
Well, we hope you learned something about turbochargers. Unfortunately, that's all the time we have today. Until next time, so long from Shadetree Mechanic.
For a copy of today's Shadetree Mechanic, call 1-800-456-0063 or write to the address on your screen. Refer to the offer number shown. The cost of the tape is $50.95 plus $3.50 shipping and handling.